hopefully we all came up with this graph, yes? Now, go back to your rectangular equation. We came up with x squared over 4 plus y squared over 9 equals 1. Oh, that's unfreezing. Thank you. That's the rectangular form I got. However, if I graph this, I'm going to see the full ellipse, aren't I? So this is where, when you're dealing with circles and ellipses, depending upon what path you're seeing, restricting the domain may not always work. Because if I restrict the domain from negative 2 to 2, that's not going to tell me that I want the top half of the circle, is it? Because if I graph this full entire ellipse, the domain's also going to be negative 2 to 2. So to assure that I'm only looking at the top half of the circle, instead of restricting the domain, I'm going to have to restrict the range. So if you're only seeing the top half or the bottom half of the circles or the ellipses, you need to restrict the range versus the domain. So the range restriction on this rectangular equation is going to be from 0, less than or equal to y, less than or equal to 3. So that's why some problems, the range is going to be restricted versus the domain. You always use a domain restriction unless it doesn't produce the graph that you want. Then you have to use the range. All right? Questions?
I will see you guys after.